Acitor's Disbulletin October 2010 highlight. The eyes have it. Sonam shows off a neat trick for making your eyes pop at a day event. Rather than adding uncolored eyeshadows, she simply chose one color and applied it along her lower lash line. The rest of her makeup is sheer and neutral, which leaves this colorful accent the center of attention. Channeling the Material Girl? Is it homage or just a really lame knockoff? I'm gonna go with the latter. Malika S. attended the Doha Film Festival wearing this monstrosity. Can't say I'm surprised given her usual red carpet attire. It's more of the same, really. The lady loves those cutouts. On another note, is it just me or has she been promoting his for a really, really long time? I mean, she keeps cropping up all around the world promoting her movie. Sorry, lady, but no amount of tireless self-promotion is going to make me want to see this film. The family that poses together, stays together. The Bakshans turned on some group posing action once again at the 57th National Film Awards in New Delhi. Big B and Ab Jr. were both award recipients at this event. It's great that the whole family showed up in support. I swear, Shtananda was there too. Not that you'd know it from any of the photos. I love Lara E's Kanjivrum sari. As I've said before, Lara E would look amazing in a burlap sack. But, in a pure silk sari, she's just stunning. This particular sari has a temple border noted by the peaks you see. I love the color combination. Green and purple with gold zari and delicate gold jewelry. Lara E could be the brand ambassador for Kanjivrum. While her style factor is impossibly high, I do wish she'd visit her colorist and take her hair color up a couple of shades. Currently, the light brown washes her out in my opinion. However, her makeup is spot on in its simplicity. She's got her usual heavily defined eyes, kohl and mascara, baby. A neutral lip, and flawless skin. Well, here is one photo of Shta as proof that she did in fact attend. Poor girl, maybe she's just camera shy. Can't really blame her if she is, the Bakshan machine is rather camera crazy. Navratri/Dussehra/Durga Puja wrap up. Rani and Dia attended Durga Puja in lovely saris. Being Bengali, Rani really pulled out the stops with her choices. I believe she's, appropriately enough, wearing Sabyasachi, a fellow Bengali. I love both of these ladies for choosing very traditional looks for puja. Very rich and luxurious fabrics and accessories, but not the least bit flashy. Although, Rani's navy blue number is rather reminiscent of a Czech tablecloth. But still, both look fabulous. Dia's capped sleeve blouse is sweet and Rani's white sari is a traffic stopper. Actress and model Lisa Ray, is a cancer survivor herself. Throughout her battle with cancer, she was very candid about the disease and its toll on her both physically and emotionally. As a survivor, she is a tireless crusader for breast cancer awareness and fundraising for a cure. She was absolutely radiant at a recent breast cancer awareness event in Mumbai, hence the hot pink. It's a pretty fantastic color at baseline. But as a symbol of the fight against breast cancer, we love it even more. We here at Disbulletin wish Lisa well in her endeavors and certainly hope to see her return to films in the future. Shabash for all your efforts in this arena, Lisa. YBTJ, One Shoulder Edition. These lovelies were in attendance at the same Tilkatur Week Bash. Both Rani and Karisma wore one shoulder numbers. My question for you is, who wore it better? Rani's bright blue hue combined with the slightly sloppy draping just didn't cut it for me. Plus, when you have a bold color and the dress is already a one shoulder number, is it really necessary that the other be a cutout sleeve? On the other hand, the classic black color plus a looser, yet not sack-like, silhouette are every new mama's godsend. I have to go with Karisman on this one. Filmy forecast, Anil Kapoor opposite Tom Cruise. Yes, you read that right. Fresh off his turn on American TV's 24, the pompadoured one is reportedly playing a villain in the latest iteration of the Mission Impossible franchise. This guy is truly getting better with age. I love it. Having a good day, are we? And so it cycles back with Miss K. At this rate, I may have to pull a couple of mixologists off the Goss Bureau and place them on permanent Kangana watch. I swear, I don't want to keep talking about her, but when she's having an off day, she's a walking disaster. That said, every once and again, she manages a good day too. At the promo of Knockout on Kodustad, she was downright luminous. And I love the Mandarin. Both the color and the collar. This Anrikali is charming in its simplicity, as is Kangana's frizz-free, thank the gods, demurely pulled back hair. Too much fabric, that is. Alas, Ronnie did not get her act together over the course of LFW. On the final day, she in fact chose her most unflattering look, this ghastly wide-leg romper. Eek. Can we just say that the fabric swallows her up and only makes shorties appear even shorter? Frankly, the proportions don't help out width-wise either. Let's just leave it at that. Strike a pose. Who would've thought this day would ever come? I mean, frankly speaking, Shri has only gotten better with age, so I always considered hers to be a constantly rising bar that would prove nearly impossible for her daughters to match. Well, it seems Shri's body has outdone her at Nita Lala's show. Snapped striking identical poses. Have a look-see at this mother-daughter duo and let me know what you think. Now, we can't really fault Shri in this case. After all, she was walking for Miss Lala, so let's be clear about where the blame for this shiny mess likes. Cough Nita, cough Lala. Photo, Getty.